नमस्ते, प्रणाम। गीता ध्यान। ओम पार्थाय प्रतिबोधिताम् भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथिताम् पुराण मुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीम् भगवतीम् अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम् अम्बत्वा अनुसंदधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणी। ओ भगवद्गीता विथ विच लॉर्ड नारायणा हिमसेल्फ गेव एनलाइटनमेंट टू अर्जुना, द एंशंट सेज व्यास इंक्लूडेड इट इन द महाभारत। ओ गॉडेस Showerer of the nectar like knowledge of non-dualism contained in your 18 chapters. O my affectionate mother, destroyer of rebirth, I meditate upon thee. Krishna Vandana. वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं। O son of Vasudeva, slayer of Kansa and Chanur, extreme delight for Mother Devaki, O Lord Krishna, the supreme teacher of the universe, my salutations to you. So Sri Krishna further telling us about the greatness of this knowledge that we have earned. This will be the 36th shloka of the Jnana Karma Sannyasa Yoga, the fourth adhyaya of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Shri Krishna has started telling us the greatness of knowledge. And in the previous shloka, 35th verse, Shri Krishna has told us that having got that knowledge, yat jnatva, having got that, having got which, na punar moham evam yasyasi pandava, o pandava, o Arjuna, you will never ever get under this delusion, under this confusion. And not only that, forget about this confusion. This knowledge, yena bhutani asheshena, all the creation, irrespective of which beings, human beings, animal beings, this entire creation, drakshasyam anyathomayi, you will see this within yourself. You will perceive all the creation within yourself and also in me, in Sri Krishna, in the Lord. That is the greatness of knowledge. And today, in this 36th shloka, Sri Krishna is again going to tell us what magic this knowledge, acquiring this knowledge of how to do karma, what this knowledge can do. 36th shloka. Api chedasi papebhyah sarvebhyah papakrutmah sarvajnanaplavenaiv vrujinam santarishyasi. This is another great teaching Sri Krishna is giving. What knowledge is going to do? This knowledge. Api cheta si, even if, api is even, cheta, if, si, you are what? Even if you are apebhya sarvebhya papakrutmaha, even if you are the sinner, apebhya, compared to other sinners, sarve pihad, all other sinners, apam apakrutmaha, even if you are most sinful, apakrutmaha, even if you are the most sinful person among all the sinners, so what? Now that you have got the knowledge, sarva jnana plavenaiva, jnana Plavena. Jnana plavena is like raft which makes us float on the water. If we have to cross a river, we get onto the floor, raft. This raft of knowledge, ज्ञानप्लवेन एव सर्वं रुजिनं संतरिष्यसि. दिस राफ्ट ऑफ नॉलेज दिस विल मेक यू क्रॉस, दिस विल हेल्प यू क्रॉस व्हाट ऑल द बैरियर्स ऑफ द सिन. रुजिनं संतरिष्यसि, रुजिनं इज सिन. विद दिस raft of knowledge you will cross over all the sins that you have committed. You may be the most sinful person, the worst person as far as committing sin is concerned, but with this knowledge, with this raft of knowledge, you will just float away across all those sins and you shall become free from all the sins that you have committed except prarabdha. So this is what Sri Krishna is now telling Arjuna and to us about what the knowledge can do. Even if you be the most sinful of all sinners, papebhyah sarvebhyah papakrutmah, shall you cross over all sins by the raft of knowledge. Will cross over. Sarva, sarvam rujinam santarishyasi. You will cross over all the sins with which you will cross. You will cross it with jnana plavena. You will cross all those, that sea of sea, that deep ocean of sins. You will cross with this raft of knowledge. Sin and virtue are the obverse and reverse of the same fact, which is karma. Any karma we do, it has two sides, like a coin. Every karma is attached with virtue and vice. Every karma is attached with, like we are breathing. We are breathing. We are providing the life force to our body, which is a good thing, isn't it? But in the process, what is happening? We are also inhaling so many microbes, we are putting an end to their lives also. With every breathe out, maybe our the breath coming out is hitting so many microbes around us. They may be dying, we don't know. In fact, we are committing a sin there. But we are also providing that vital energy to our body. So on the one side, we are doing great virtue to sustain this body. But simultaneously, we are also killing all those microbes, which is incurring a sin. Now, this balance of virtue and sin, this has to be effected. When one has this knowledge, sin aspect, there is no more sin aspect. It is only me doing the Lord's work. It is not I am who I am. I don't have that ownership. I don't have the ownership of the process of my breathing. I don't have the ownership of eating the food, which is also at one point of time, which was a living matter. So, once this sense of I doing goes off, there is no sin. It is the Lord who is doing. Why should I be worried how many microbes are getting killed, how many lives I am eating every day through even the rice and chapati, roti that I am eating, how many vegetables I am cutting. I am not doing anything then. Once knowledge is dawned. So, according to the use made of it, the same karma presents itself as sin or virtue. Look at the dilemma of Arjuna, that he had to wage war against his own cousins and all those evil-minded, evil-doers, the wrongdoers, the unrighteous cousins had to be exterminated. Now, killing anybody is a sin. But फॉर अ क्षत्रिय लाइक अर्जुना हु इज गोइंग टू डू हिज स्वधर्म बाय एलिमिनेटिंग द विकेडनेस फ्रॉम द फेस ऑफ दिस अर्थ. इट इज द राइटियस थिंग, इट इज द मोस्ट वर्चुअस थिंग, गेटिंग ग्रीड ऑफ द एविल. He has to do it. If he does it in the spirit of I am not the doer, no evil, no sin gets attached to that action of his. In fact, it is laudable action that this great Kshatriya, he has followed his Swadharma and he has eliminated the wickedness from the face of this earth. There is no sin attached to it. The ignorant do karma so as to get entangled in it as sin. That is how the one without knowledge, he will get entangled in the sinful act of the karma, sinful aspect of the karma. The ignorant ones, those who don't have any knowledge, those who have not got any knowledge, they will get entangled in the sinful aspect of the karma, not the virtue. Knowledge, therefore, is the only means to absolve all sin. As the unfordable river, a river which is difficult, extremely difficult to cross with a very high current. You cannot swim across that river. You will get yourself washed away. Then what we do? We prepare a raft and sitting comfortably on that raft, we cross over that turbulent river. Absolutely comfortable, that raft will protect us, and knowledge is that raft of crossing over that turbulent waves of the sin called as sin. Knowledge is the raft which will make us cross all that shaky and turbulent and so much boisterous waters of that river. So that is what Sri Krishna tells. This is how. You may be the most sinful among all the sinners. You might have committed n number of sins in your life. But the moment knowledge dawns, the moment you get that enlightenment, the moment you get that illumination, all the sins just vanish. You are over. You cross over all those sins and you become one with the Lord, like he said in the previous shloka, that with that knowledge a person becomes one with this entire one. He starts seeing all the creation within himself and becomes one with the Lord. Not only is the creation within his own self, but he also sees that creation as part of the Lord and his oneness with the Lord, and that's what makes him comfortably cross over all those the turbulent waves of sins that he has created all along. And that is a wonderful, in fact a confidence building teaching that Sri Krishna has given. Go after that knowledge, don't run away from that knowledge. This knowledge is so precious. This knowledge is so invaluable. This is what is going to sustain us. This is what is going to lead us to our mukti, to our moksha, and getting rid of that cycle of birth and death, birth and death, birth and death. So that is Sri Krishna's teaching in this 36th shloka of the Jnana Karma Sannyasa Yoga, highlighting the greatness of the knowledge in eliminating all the sins we might have done so far. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Sri Krishna Arpanamastu. Jai Sri Ram Krishna. Jai Thakur.